So in this video, I'm gonna do a spherical shape, but this one will have like a kind of a bumpy texture. More so, I was thinking of like something, you know, like a toad's skin texture or something like that. So it's going to be really, you know, bumpy. And you'll see pretty much what I'll do. And again, I'm going to pretty much follow what I did before of having the light coming from the upper right. So this area is going to be in shadow as usual, and I can just pretty much, you know, just shade that in, even though I'm going to draw over it. And what you'll notice is that what I'll be using are just pretty much just little small forms like this. That's all it will be about, you know, just varying the sizes a little bit, and that's it. But of course I'm going to, you know, go in and make some a little bit more detailed than others, and emphasize the whole area of light and shadow. So again, the main emphasis here is to create this, you know, volume of going from light to dark, but at the same time trying to effectively create a sense of shadow. What I will do with this one, just like I did with the asteroid one, is that I'll try to I'll break the contour. See, like that, for example. See, and by doing that, you know, that strengthens the illusion of texture a lot. Okay, so that's why I kind of made it a little bit broken. And yeah, I think that's basically the idea. But what I'll do is the sides of the little, these little small forms, little bumps, the sides that are away from light, this side will be pretty dark, and the ones in the light area will, like in this area, you'll see how I deal with it. I'll make it a little bit scan, just like I've been doing with the other examples that I've been doing. I think that's about it. So yeah, again, you know, see, I'm doing the same thing in pretty much all of them. Notice I'm having the, you know, you can see, feel the volume of the form. You know, it's, everything is getting lighter as it goes over like that. But I'm pretty much being consistent in the type of textures that I create. And all I just used was, you know, these simple little scribbly shapes to create the same thing. And it's pretty much the same thing that I did with all of these other textures. same thing. Yeah, so you're getting a glimpse of the one I plan to do next. It's on like a scale. But it's, you know, this is very good exercise for you whenever you're trying to, you know, just exercise your sense of capturing texture. Because, you know, the thing is, which is cool about pen and ink, is that I can apply this texture to drawing like 100 different things, all right? So once you have a feel of capturing a certain texture, it's just up to you, you know, to decide how you want to use it.